NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is video number 45 in our series, Create a RubyGem, NerdDice. So in our previous video, we had written the method in die that lets us include or exclude each die in the total, and we wrote some failing specs for that those highest and lowest methods. And so we'll now go in and we'll implement those methods, make those specs pass in this video. Go in. Lowest, and the defaults on these are going to be nil. And we're going to return self at the end. So that'll maybe get a couple of these passing. I would have expected two to be passing, but I only got one to pass. Undefined methods because I did not define these in the lowest block. Up to 10 failures. Just go with line 267. Right. Expected 41. I got 36. We've got a 17 and a 19 here. Let's make sure it is consistently those same values. It appears to be. So we should now have it be a 19 here. same situation here with a 17 and a 19. That should be the 17. Let's take a look at our We've got a 9 here, so we've got a 2 values here so that I have more. That's easier to read. So a 3, a 1, a 4, and a 1. So we're doing this with the highest 3, that will be an 8. And our lowest 3 be a big fat 5. And these are going to be the same values. All right, so these are all still going to fail because we haven't actually written anything interesting in our method yet. We're still at 10 failures, which is expected. So now we need to go in and let's see here. If number to take is nil, we'll have a get default to take method in both of these. This will be a private method. dice is equal to 1. Return 1. Or else you're going to return number of dice minus 1. Do that, and then actually, call this check argument, and we'll actually bring in number to take so that we can raise the error. I'm not in love with that name. Bang method, because it's going to raise an error if it fails. Just do the or equals operator. And then we're going to raise number to take. Now we're going to want to in our situation here, let's take our dice equals 3d6. We've got a 1, 4, a 2. So our lowest situation will give us 2 us in 1, 2, 4. And then we can do sort dot reverse for highest. And then it will be 0. So if number to take was 2, so let's think through this. If we have these, so this gives us 0 to 2, but we just really need to do, let's say we want to keep 2 here. We're going to do each with index, do die index if die. Equal to 2 in this case. Oh. Whatever the name is included in total. Let me just try doing it this way then. So, and then we'll take a look at our specs and see if we solve for it. So, we want dice.sort, and highest we want dice.sort.reverse each with index do total equals false if index is greater than or equal to number to take. This is still going to fail because we haven't done anything to our total method yet. So let's now go back to our total method. see how close we get. So down to 4 failures, which is good. With disadvantage. So down to 2 failures, and now similarly to how we did the alias in die method, or our die class. Those are all passing now. Run the whole suite. Everything's passing. We'll look at our coverage. Coverage is good. Check in with the road pirates. Are all correctable. Let's take a look at our auto-corrected total method. So select included in total sum. The value plus the bonus. Run our spec a few times. Make sure that we're still all right. So I think we're in good shape here. Let's take a look at our diff. Sure that it reflects the intended changes. I think we're ready for our commit message. Write it. So we've got our commit message. push. Move our item to done. I know this is some presumption here, but sometimes hope is a strategy. So we've got success, and we'll continue our backlog in the next video.
Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.